So next thing that comes are the predefined methods. Now, what are predefined methods? It's we have already seen how to create a method, right? On our own, right? We can create methods, we can add functionalities to the method, right? And then we can call those methods as well, right? But it's not mandatory that every time we have to create a new method only, right? And then use it. There are some methods that are already created. There are some methods that are predefined in Java. There are some methods that are predefined in some other API that we might be integrating. Let's say if we talk about an API called Selenium. Selenium is basically an API. If we talk about an API called APM, APM is basically an API. Now, there are n number of things we come across whenever we are working on any Java project, a core Java project itself, right? So there are many APIs that we generally integrate, and in what API contains, they contains a project that is already built in there. The project that contains some classes, some methods, right? So all those methods are predefined. You need not to write those methods again. Right, so you'll just be calling the existing functionality from that particular API. You'll just be calling the method from that particular API. Now, if we talk about one of the methods, this math dot, this math is a class, right? This is a predefined class in Java itself. If you search for this particular class, if you let's say, if I navigate to open up Chrome and write math class Java doc. Right, I'll go to this link. Right, now if you see over here, you'll find there are a couple of methods available inside this math class, right? Now we can call these methods, we can call this method, and we can actually execute the functionality of this method, right? Now, same way, there is a method called random. What it returns, a double value with a positive sign greater than or equal. This method is actually used to generate random numbers. This method will actually gonna generate random numbers for us. So this math class is generally implemented to handle a lot of methods, mathematical calculations, right? And all these calculations, all these things are present over here as a method. So if you want to take out exponentials, you'll be calling this method. If you want to take out logarithms, you'll be generate logarithms, you'll be calling this method, right? If you want to get the maximum value, the minimum value between two values, then you'll be calling these methods, right? So the code is already written over there. You need not to write the code again for creating the maximum, like calling the maximum number from a list or from two numbers. So you need not to write the code again. You just need to call this method and it will gonna do that particular job. Now, same way, if I look at this method, this is a random method, right? So just take a look at this method and see, do I need to pass anything inside this method? There are no parameters, right? So I need not to pass any argument to this method. And what is the return type of this method? This is basically double. Double means that it will gonna return some value with a decimals like this, right? So it will gonna return as a double value. So what this method will actually gonna do, it will actually gonna generate a random number which is between 0.0 till 1.0, right? So it means any number above 0.0 and till 0.999, it will actually gonna generate that random number. The other thing over here, this method is a static method, right? Now, what are statics and non-static? Any method where we have written like this, public static void and the method name, or public static int and the method name, those are called as static method. Any method without this static keyword are the non-static method. So we haven't studied about what static and non-static are, although we'll be taking a look at this in our coming lectures, right? But for the time being, just understand it like this way. If any method is static, then we can call that method without creating an object of that class. We need not to create an object of this math class in order to call this random method. I can directly call this method either by saying math, the class name dot the method name directly. Right, I can call it like this. I need not to create any object of this class. So what we'll do, we'll go back to Eclipse and create a new class name as random numbers. Right, so what I'll do, I'll directly call this class and I'll say math dot, see, I get all the list, all these methods belong to the math class, right? And the method that we need to call is random. So I can directly call this method in this way. Now this method was actually returning me a double value. So I actually need to create a variable of double type. I'll say double num equal to this. So let us print this num and see what it actually gonna return. So let us save this and run this. And it will actually going to generate a random number. Every time I run it, the numbers will be changed. See, every time it is actually returning a random number, right? So what is the code written inside this method? We need not to worry about it, right? This is already present inside the Java library. Java is already a stable software, right? We need not to worry about what this random method, if the code written is correct or not. We know that when we call this random method, it will actually gonna return a double value, right? Any number between 0.0 to 1.0, right? So we n number of time we call it, all the time the value gets changed. So we only need to worry about how we need to call this method. We need not to worry about what is actually written inside this method. Now let us do some manipulations with this method. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna multiply this with 10, right? Now what happens, this random method, it works up till it prints anything above 0.0 to less than 1.0, that is 0.99. So if I multiply it with 10, so one decimal gets increased. So now it will gonna work up till 9.99, right? So if I run this now, you will see that a decimal is now shifted to this position. So again, I run it, every time it will gonna generate a number that should be less than 9.99 only. It will not gonna generate any number above that. Same way, if I say multiply by 100, again, it will be 99. It will actually gonna run up till 99.99. Now again, if you take a look over here, with the number, there are many floating points that are being generated. Now what I want, I just want to get the value which is without the floating points, right? So without any decimal. Now here the concept that comes is type casting, right? So there are two things that you will actually be seeing. One is type cast, and one is conversion, right? Either we can cast it or we can convert it, right? So we're gonna look at the conversion thing as well. The very first thing will be typecasting it. Now what typecasting means that what typecasting will actually gonna do, it will actually gonna reduce this number to a shorter format. So we're gonna have some loss over here, right? So what we need to do, we need to typecast it into integer, something like this. So I'll say int, right? Now what this thing will gonna do, this thing will actually gonna remove all the float values from here, right? And if we are writing it like this, if I just save it, so what I need to do, when I'm typecasting it like this, I need to convert it into an integer number, right? So that I'll get some shorter value, right? So when I run this again, I got answer like 0. Why? Because we need to put a bracket over here as well, right? Based on the BODMAS rule. So as soon as I run this again, you can see now this is only generating integer numbers, right? All right. And same way, if I would have not changed this to integer, if I would have let it remain as double, then it would have generated decimal values, right? So I don't want to generate these decimal values. I'll just change this type to integer as well, right? So the now the numbers that are being generated are between 0 to 99, right? Now this math.random, this is a very important class. This math class is a very important class. In terms you're working with any API, probably if I take an example of Selenium API itself, sometimes it happens that you need to select some random values, right? I got this question a lot. Let's say I take an example, I go to this link, check boxes, right? Now over here, in this section, you see four checkboxes over here. Now, I got a question that I need to write some logic which should select any random number, any random checkbox when I execute this code, right? It could select two or it could select four, right? So what I can do, I can go over here and I can say five over here, right? Now what happens, it will actually gonna generate any number between 0 to 5. So see 2, 3, and it returns 0, it returns 4, it should also return 1. It is generating it randomly, right? So it will not generate anything above 4. So this thing you can use and you can handle anything using the random numbers. Right, so these are what pre-defined methods are. So if I show you another API from like Selenium, if you go over here, if you look at the Java document, if I go to this Java document, right, these are the classes. If I pick any one of the class named as, let's say I pick up the class as default Selenium, although it is this class is almost deprecated in the market, right? But if you see over here in the method summary, you got all the predefined methods. If you want to automate your website, you can call this method check. It will actually gonna toggle a checkbox and a radio button. If you want to click on any link, button, checkboxes, what code that is written behind these methods, you need not to worry about that code. And you just directly need to call this method. And see, the return type of this method is just void. Right, so you just need to call this method, pass on the argument, and it will directly gonna click on that link, right? And in order to call this method, this is not a static method, right? Although what are static, non-static, we're gonna discuss about it. So what you need to do, you just need to create an object of this class and call the method with the object preference. That is all that you need to do. There are some methods that are returning string as well. So you can store them inside a string type, right? So this is how we actually read the Java documents as well for different from